Well, good morning, church family. It is Friday, May the 1st. Praise the Lord, April is over with. It has been a crazy, crazy April. That's for sure. One that many, many people will never, ever forget. One that we'd like to forget, but unfortunately we will not forget. I hope today you are doing well. I love you. I miss you. And can't wait to get into today's devotion. I hope that it encourages you and that today you, no matter what has gone on in your life, circumstances or whatever, that today you just rest in God's peace, rest in His truth, and rest in His arms. That's my prayer for you today. Today's devotion comes out of Isaiah chapter 35, verses 1 through 4. And just like always, I'm going to read it and then talk about it just for a brief second or two. So let's read out of Isaiah chapter 35, verses 1 through 4. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom like the crocus. It shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord and the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who have an anxious heart, be strong, fear not. That's our verse. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with the recompense of God. He will come and save you. This is written, Isaiah is writing this to the nation of Israel. At the time, they were kind of being a little rebellious people. And he is writing this to the small amount of people that are following him and saying, be strong, fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance, with the recompense of God. He will come and save you. But what I want to focus on today is the truth of what it says prior to those verses. It says, and the truth is this, is that God strengthens those that are weak. If you're feeling weak today, if you're feeling, like it says, if you feel like you just have weak hands, you have no energy, if you feel like you can't stand, God gives the weak strength to stand. It says, strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who have an anxious heart, be strong, fear not. He, and a little bit further down, he will come and save you. Now, I know some of you are excited today because the beaches are opening up here in Nassau County. And there's a little spark of hope in that. People are going out and getting a little bit refreshed. I've already seen pictures on Facebook this morning, and that's exciting. But I know that some of us are still in our homes. Some of us are scared to go out. My prayer is that today, if you find yourself with those weak hands, if you find yourself that have weak knees, and I'm not just talking about knees like my knees that are horrible anyway, but I'm talking about you're struggling in your faith, or you're struggling to just go day by day to live. God gives the weak strength to stand, and He will do that for you today. Be courageous, be strong, and fear not, for your God will save you, as according as what it says right there in verse 4. So I hope you are encouraged today by that. I love you. I care for you. Let's pray. God, I just want to thank you for this day, the sunshine, the coolness of this morning. God, I thank you for the fact that we here in Nassau are able to go and to the beaches again and to be able to walk on it. And it resonates with your glory, God. It resonates with your just your majesty. And Lord, I just want to pray for all of us who are feeling weak today, who are feeling like they can't stand, who are feeling that they cannot stand in their faith, or they're just tired. My prayer, God, is that today, Lord, that they or be strong and they shall not fear, and that the God, that you would firm their knees so they can stand, Lord, in your word. God, that you give them strength in their hands so that they can work, God, and they'll be able to get things done. They feel productive today. Lord, that's my prayer for us. Lord, I love you. Thank you for this time. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, church, I love you. I'm praying for you. Can't wait to see you. If you have not seen the Pastor Zach's video about reopening and gathering again on May the 17th, check out our Facebook page. It's on there, and you will be able to kind of get an idea of what we're going. There will be more information laid out a little bit later, and directions, more detailed directions with that. But as for right now, it's an exciting time because we do hopefully see a chance where we can all get back together again. I love you. Praying for you. Be encouraged. Get into the truth of God's word, and listen to its truth. And as always, in Christ Jesus, there is hope. God bless and have a great day.